You are a fraud for using templates. Now, I've never actually had anybody say this to me, but for a long time as a professional, I resisted the idea that I could use templates in my professional work. No, see, templates in my mind were for people who didn't know how to use After Effects. They were for people who weren't motion designers. But I was a motion designer. I was an artist, a creative, which means I thought that everything I made had to be made from the ground up. Everything. That's what my clients expected. That's what my clients wanted. And that is why my clients were hiring me. I've come to realize a very crucial lesson. And that lesson is the thesis of this video, which is not using templates was holding me back. And it's holding you back too. Now that's a bold statement, I know, but let me explain. Obviously, there's a lot of concerns that come when thinking about using templates in your professional work. I've come up with three that I want to address in this video, and then I want to explain how not using templates is actually holding you back as a motion designer. And by the way, if I don't address your concern in this video, leave that concern in the comment section below and let's discuss it. Okay, so the first concern is that a client will find out that you're using a template. Let's look at this two ways. First is, I think that this fear is based off of an assumption on your part as a motion designer. That assumption being that the client's primary reason for hiring you is that you can do something that they can't. The logic goes something like this. Using a template is easy. If using a template is easy, the client could do it themselves. If the client could do it themselves, then why are they hiring me? Hiring you to do something just because the client can't do it is not always the primary reason why they are hiring you. They might be hiring you because they just don't have time to do it themselves, or they just don't want to do it themselves. But also, I think we take for granted how hard it would be for somebody who's never used After Effects before, who has no experience or very little experience with After Effects, to download a project file and make even the smallest adjustments to that project file. Because believe me, I've seen veteran editors break down in tears trying to use After Effects for the first time. Number two, let's think about the logic of being caught using a template. What would the client need to know in order to catch you? Well, they would have to recognize the template. How would they recognize the template that you're using? Well, they probably needed to have seen that template somewhere. Where would they have seen that template? Well, they probably would have seen it on whatever marketplace you bought the template from. Well, why were they on that marketplace? Because they're using templates too. They recognize the value of using templates, leveraging other people's work to get the job done. Now, let's talk about the second concern you might have, and that is simply that using templates takes the fun out of the creative process. Now, here's a little bit of a dose of reality that might be a hard pill for you to swallow as a creative, and that is your clients see you as a service provider first and a creator second. Most of the time, your clients are not hiring you to win them a Vimeo staff pick. Your clients' goals are more likely a lot more practical than paying you to create a piece of artwork. All is not lost, because I want to introduce you to a concept called kit bashing. Now, the term kit bashing comes from prop makers and miniature makers for films taking different pieces of race car kits and making something new out of it. The most prominent example is something I like to call the Millennium Falcon. So, kit bashing is a valid form of creativity, and from my experience, both in my own experience using templates and in my discussions with other motion designers, this is really the way that templates are used in the industry. Most of the time, a template will contain something you can use, but the rest you will just throw out. And a lot of times, projects can involve kit bashing different parts of different templates along with the stuff that you make from scratch. Okay, and the last concern I want to address in this video is templates can become a crutch. Now, certainly templates can become a crutch, but I think if you have this fear, then that's probably a good sign that it's not going to become a crutch for you. Also, you have a decision when using templates. You can let it become a crutch, or you can turn it into an opportunity to learn from a professional. Look, think about the kind of people who can make and sell templates. They're able to sell templates because they're good at what they do. So when you use that template, it is like being able to open up the project file of a professional and dissect what and how and why they make the decisions that they do in terms of design and methodology and everything else. So using templates is a massive opportunity to learn, and it is one of the many ways I have learned and grown as a motion designer. Okay, so like I said, the thesis of this video is not using templates was holding me back, and it's holding you back too. And now I want to explore three key ways that not using templates in your professional work is holding you back. First way is that it's limiting your earning potential. The second way is it's limiting your potential growth as a motion designer. And the third way is it's limiting your competitiveness. As the saying goes, time is money. At the end of the day, as a motion designer, all you're really selling your client is your time. So when you take on a project and you have a budget, you have to look at that project as how much of my time is this budget purchasing and what can I accomplish in that time. In some situations, the budget is just not there to justify the amount of time it would take you to create everything from scratch. But if you find yourself in these situations, but you refuse to utilize and leverage work that other people have already done to get you ahead, then you are leaving money on the table. Look, I've had to learn this lesson the hard way. I've stubbornly stuck to my guns and said, no, I'm doing everything from scratch, and I've lost money on projects that didn't have the budget to support that. And I not only lost money on those projects, but I also lost money because I lost opportunities for other projects I could have taken on had I got those projects done earlier. Now, using templates on a project doesn't just save you time, it saves you creative energy. Your creative energy is not infinite. You can become creatively fatigued. And if you want to grow as a motion designer, then you need to save that creative energy for those big budget clients. Those projects are where real growth truly happens, and you don't want to be creatively spent when those opportunities come along. Having that creative energy when it counts, that is what makes you competitive. So speaking of competitiveness, what does the existence of these marketplaces tell us? Well, it tells us there is demand, because without demand, these marketplaces that sell templates would cease to exist. But what does demand tell us? The fact that there is demand for templates tells us that other motion designers are using it. And there's really no shame in leveraging templates when it makes sense. So if you're stubbornly refusing to not use templates in your professional work, you are willfully putting yourself at a disadvantage and you're falling behind the competition. Now, with everything said thus far, I want to reiterate that templates cannot replace good design skills. If you're a motion designer, you will always have to learn good design. And it may seem weird to hear, but if you want to grow as a motion designer, embrace the role that templates and other pre-made assets can play in your creative workflow. Now, if you like this video or I gave you something to think about, then make sure you hit that like button. The most time-consuming part of making this video was actually the writing process. The post-production on this video only took about a day to complete, and that's thanks to Motion Array. I got all the motion graphics and the stock footage for this video from Motion Array, and that's because of all the marketplaces I've ever used to download templates, Motion Array has the highest quality selection to choose from, and it's not even close. Plus, it's not just templates. Motion Array has music, stock photos, stock footage. They even have a video review tool that you can use to get feedback from your clients. I actually canceled my Frame.io subscription in favor of Motion Array's review tool. Now, with a subscription to Motion Array, you get unlimited downloads to all this stuff, and it's quite affordable. Viewers of my channel can get an additional $50 off an annual subscription. If you want to support the channel and you want to check out Motion Array, go click the link in the description. Okay, that does it for today's video. If you want more videos like this that are less tutorial and more topic discussion type videos, show me by hitting that like button. But don't worry, we'll always have more tutorials on the way, so make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss anything. I'm also interested to know your thoughts on this subject. Do you use templates in your professional work? Why or why not? Do you have any concerns I didn't address in this video? Leave your thoughts in the comment section below and let's discuss it. Anyway, that does it for this video. We'll see you guys in the next video.